Hey guys, Will here again with Happily Ever Outdoors. Today I want to do a quick review for you on the Lawson Blue Ridge Camping Hammock. Now, Lawson Hammock refers to this as a hybrid tent hammock, which I think is a pretty good description, and you'll see once we get this thing set up. By the way, I just want to say thank you to Lawson Hammock for hooking us up with a discount on this hammock so we could do a review. I want to let you guys know that I'm not a paid representative of the company, so any opinions that I express in this video or statements that I make are my own. Okay guys, so a couple things I want to say about this hammock real quick. I do think it comes well packaged. You can see it comes with a drawstring bag. Everything goes together fairly compact, kind of about the size of like a bedroll, something like that. Now this hammock is 4.25 pounds, so it's definitely not in the ultralight category. And of course, if you add any other accessories to it, like carabiners, you know, the rope you're gonna bring to hang it from, that's gonna add a little more weight to it as well. So you gotta take that into consideration. But it's a very well-designed kit. Everything rolls up very nicely and fits inside the bag that's provided. So thumbs up to Lawson Hammock for that. All right, so let's roll this out so you guys can see what we're working with. All right, guys, so taking a look at what we've got, you can see the tree hugger straps, which is what you're going to use to secure it to the tree. Now, that's not an absolute necessity. You can hang a hammock with just rope. These just make it a little bit easier. Those are available on Lawson Hammock's website. However, they do not manufacture them. They're made by a third party. And they're a fairly basic strap, nothing to really brag about in terms of features, but they are very sturdy, very practical, and they work, so I do like those. Next, you can see the tent poles that come in sets of two. And you'll see when I set this up how those will be utilized. You can see they have a curve built into them. So you'll have two of those. These are lightweight, by the way. I think they're aluminum. So that doesn't add too much weight to the kit. Now this is what comes included with the kit. You'll get two basic, get that where you can see it. Sorry about that. Two basic metal hooks right there. So those are what you're going to use to secure the rope to your hammock. So you'll see that. Next, this is some stuff I added to the kit. I've got two lengths of rope that I've already pre-cut and burned the ends. Two roundabouts, what I need, with a lot of slack, obviously, because trees can be spaced, you know, closer or further apart, but enough that it should work for most situations. So I went ahead and did that. I've also got a little setup I'll show you, two little carabiners that I found, and some cord that I used to help stabilize the hammock. So I'll show you that. Once again, that's added on, that didn't come with the kit. And then I have two large metal carabiners, locking carabiners, not included in the kit as well, but I use those to replace these because I would prefer to have a locking carabiner just the way I like to set it up, my personal preference. So I'll show that to you guys. All right, now let's take a look at the hammock. As you can see, it does have an included rain cover, which works very well. Covers the whole hammock. Without the rain cover, this is gonna have a mesh top, which is all built in, just like a tent. It's all solid, one piece. And then you would just pull the rain cover over the top and then that would be attached. Now if you're used to hammocks like you see from Eno, some other companies like that, what you'd refer to as a gathered end hammock, meaning that the hammock gets narrower towards the end, it's built that way. This hammock is a little bit different. As you can see here, it does have a structure to it. You can see the web of cord that comes up that supports the ends of the hammock with a cross brace that goes apart, which by the way splits in two in the middle so the hammock folds up more compact, so those will just lock in together. So this is a more structured hammock. I like it because it gives you a little more of a firm base to lay on. You don't sag as much on the hammock depending on how you hang it. And so if you're someone who has issues with back problems, things like that, I personally think that you'll probably be more comfortable in this hammock than you may be in some other hammocks. Of course, you'd have to try it for yourself. Everybody's different. That's just my personal opinion. So guys, here's what's cool about hammock camping. You don't have to find the ideal place to set up your hammock. With a tent, you've got to worry about sticks, rocks on the ground, you know, the potential for water runoff, depending on where you're set up. There's a lot of different factors you got to consider setting up a tent. With a hammock, you're up off the ground, so you can go on uneven terrain. There can be rocks and sticks underneath you, and no matter what, you should be good. As long as you have two trees that are reasonably spaced apart, you can get this hammock set up. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and throw up these tree hugger straps, and then I will quickly show you how to set this hammock up. All right, guys, so next we want to get our hammock prepped to hang. So what I'm going to go ahead and do, I'm going to pull the rain cover off. I'm going to go ahead and lock the two support poles together on either end, and we'll go ahead and run our poles through as well, which is going to support the mesh of this hammock tent. All right, guys, so you're just going to slide that pole through. There's a channel that it'll glide right through, and then you'll see little metal grommets there that you can put the end into, just like you'd see with a regular camping tent. All right, so that's all prepped. I'm going to go ahead and secure all the gear I'm going to need to hang this stuff into my pocket, so I'll have it when I'm ready, and let's hang this thing up. One of the things I'm going to tell you guys is don't stress too much about getting it exactly right, because it's really not like a super exact science. You don't have to have the straps exactly the same height. It doesn't have to be perfectly level, because once this hammock is hanging, it's going to sort of level itself out to a certain extent. So just get it up, play with it, get the tension right, and you know, just don't worry about it too much. Don't overthink it. All right, so as you guys can see, like I mentioned, it's not really level right now. No big deal. All we gotta do, go back over to this side, tighten it up a little bit, it'll get it where I want it. All right, guys, so as you can see, we've got the hammock hung now. That was really fast, really easy, and with a little bit of practice, I'm sure you guys will be able to do it even faster. The only things that I did different from the kit that's included in the bag, you can see my large locking carabiners that I'm using here and here on the other end to attach the hammock to the rope itself. Normally, that's what you would use, the small included metal S-hooks that I showed you before. There's really nothing wrong with these. They do work. I just kind of prefer to have a closed carabiner so I can just pull the rope through, slide it. I don't know. I just like it a little better. So that's up to you. So once again, these are included, so you don't need to purchase carabiners, but I choose to use them. But we've got the hammock hung. The only issue I run into is I found this hammock to be a little bit unstable sometimes, depending on how tight you have the thing hung. I mean, the tighter you get it, the tighter the material is going to be inside, and the more firm of support you're going to have. So if you want it tighter so the middle doesn't sag as much, the trade-off is this tent starts to get a little bit tippy from side to side. The best way I found to address that was through this neat little setup I picked up from the store. I want to say I paid $7 for this, and I'll unravel this so you guys can see it. These are from a company called Night Eyes. They are figure 9 carabiners, and it also comes with this section of cord. It's kind of like a heavy duty shoelace almost, so I don't know how long that's going to last. I may end up replacing it with paracord eventually, but that's what I'm using it for right now. So it came with two links which I tied together, but you can see the way this works, you can just loop it around and then the cord will lock into there, so you'll be able to, you know, tighten this, adjust this, tie it, untie it very easily. And so what we're going to do, I have two of these, and we're going to hook them on either corner on one side of the hammock and wrap them around the tree, so it'll help to stabilize it a little bit. So you guys will see what I'm talking about here in a second. You can see all I'm really doing is just pulling a length of cord around the tree down low, and what that's going to do is make that end of the hammock a little more stable, so when you're climbing in and out of the hammock or when you're moving around at night, it's not going to have that tendency to try to flip on you. Okay guys, so as it hangs right now, we could go ahead and crawl in this thing and go to sleep if it was warm enough and if we weren't expecting rain overnight. You can see it is completely enclosed with no CM netting, so it's gonna keep even the little bugs out. You don't gotta worry about getting eaten up overnight. It has one large opening on one side to climb in and out, so be aware of that when you're hanging it up to make sure you get it facing the direction you want it to be. But this is good to go as a standalone right here. However, it is cold out right now, so we're gonna go ahead and use our included rain cover. All right guys, gonna do a quick walk around so you guys can get a good look at how this hammock is fully set up. As you can see, it definitely has a lot more structure than most of the hammocks that you're probably used to. You can see with that little extra cord that I added, just a little bit of customization, you've got a lot more stability. So I think I'm gonna keep hanging it that way from now on. But you can see, pretty simple setup, nothing too complicated. And this is a very well-built system. This is really sturdy material. I've slept in this thing through rainstorms and through snow and all kinds of stuff, and I have never had any kind of moisture get inside. The only issue I had at one point was a little bit of condensation started happening on the bottom of the hammock. I'm not sure exactly what was going on that night that was different, but other than that, I've never had any issues with moisture. You can see there's a lot of good attachment points for the cover. It's well secured. You've got another strap running across there. You've also got two Velcro tabs on the side, so it keeps the rain cover well attached without being super, super tight to where, you know, wind could get underneath it and yank on it and damage it over time. You can see the bracing, and you can see that it's kind of open on either end. This thing is fairly enclosed, so I could imagine with the rain cover on during warmer weather, it might get uncomfortable. I haven't tried it yet. We're in the winter season right now, but I could foresee that happening. So, but you do have an opening on either end to give you a little bit of ventilation. Let's go ahead and open this up as well. Try to do this one-handed. Hold on a second, guys. All right, so with this thing opened up, you can see, depending on how you hang it, sometimes this hammock does tend to really kind of sag to where you don't get as much of that tent-like structure to it. What I think I'm probably gonna do is keep a couple short lengths of paracord with me, because what you could do is attach a little length of paracord there and pull it down to the frame and, you know, pull that end up to tighten that up a little bit to give you a little more structure. So it just kind of depends how much slack you have in the hammock. You got more slack, it's going to sag a little more. It's tighter, it's not going to sag as much. So I get kind of claustrophobic, so I don't like it right on top of me. Some people might not care, but that's probably what I'll do to address that little issue. So some of the nice features of the inside of this hammock, you can see it does have two pockets where you can secure some of your stuff in there. It also has a hook on either end that you could hang something from. I have some LED lights, hanging light that you can clip on there. So that's what I like to do, so I can have some light inside the hammock. The material all around seems pretty sturdy. The mesh I like, it's pretty strong. You can kind of see the frame and everything there, the way this is all put together. I think everything, they did a really good job on like the stitching, the way it's put together, pretty good quality on the zippers. The only minor issue I had, which you can see there, was that when I received it, it had a small hole in one end, and Lawson Hammock actually offered to send me a new one. I told them not to worry about it, I would just patch it. So it seemed like it was some kind of, almost like a hole was melted or something, didn't seem like a cut. But that was the only minor issue I had with this hammock as far as that goes. No other issues with stitching or any holes or anything like that. So just to give you a rundown on the specs, once again, the total weight of this system is 4.25 pounds. It has an interior length of 90 inches, an interior width of 42 inches. The packing size is 22 inches by 6 inches, and the weight limit on this system is 275 pounds. So unless you are two very lightweight adults, this is going to be a one-man system. Generally, two average-size adults is going to be too much for the weight limit of this hammock. The body of the hammock is made of ripstop nylon and polypack cloth. As I mentioned, it has no CM net for the canopy to keep all the bugs out. It has a waterproof nylon border on the canopy to protect against water blowing up under the rainfly. And it has waterproof ripstop nylon rainfly included with the system. Okay guys, so what's the bottom line? What do I think of the Lawson hammock? I really like it. At first, I wasn't quite sure because it's just so different from most of the other systems I've seen. It really is a hybrid somewhere between a tent and a hammock. By the way, I didn't demonstrate for you here today, but this hammock can be used as like a standard bivy tent on the ground. So you can set it up that way as well, stake it down, and you'll be all good to go as far as that's concerned. So it really is a hybrid. As far as the weight is concerned, if you're using this thing for like car camping or maybe a short trip out in the woods where you don't have a long ways to carry it, that's probably not going to be an issue. But for somebody who's an ultralight backpacker going really long distances, the 4.25 pounds, it might be an issue for you. So that's definitely something to consider when you're looking at potentially purchasing this hammock. I would say that the rain cover that's included works extremely well. I mean, really, really good. As I mentioned earlier, went through rainstorms, snow, all kinds of stuff, and it kept me completely dry. Did a really good job of keeping the wind down too. You'd get a little bit of airflow through the ends of the hammock because that's open, but that was a good thing, so it didn't get too stuffy inside. The quality overall, the construction, the design is really, really well thought out and really well put together. Really good stitching throughout the whole thing, quality zippers, mesh, the materials they use, everything. I have no complaints there whatsoever. They did a really great job. The only issue I have with this hammock, and it's really a minor one, is that I wish it had a higher weight limit on it. It's a good size where you really could fit two adults in there, but unless you're really on the lightweight side, you're gonna be over the weight limit. So for my wife and I, this is not something we would be able to use together without exceeding the weight limit. I don't know, we might get away with it and be just fine, but I don't really want to chance that and end up blowing the hammock out and and then having no chance of any kind of warranty because I went over the weight limit. But this is great for like me and my son. We like to go camping together. He's 10 years old. So me and him could fit into this thing perfectly and not be over the weight limit. And it's just the right size for us really to get in there and get cozied up together. And because of the fact that the hammock is a little more structured and it doesn't sag and cocoon as much as some other hammocks on the market do. It's a lot more comfortable with me and him in there. We don't kind of get wadded up together. At the end of the day, this is definitely a product I would recommend you checking out. I got it cheaper than their $200 asking price, but I still think that it's well worth what they're asking for it. Very well constructed, very well designed, and it's really an all-in-one system. Other than the few things you'll need to get, like some rope, some carabiners, things like that, to tweak it to your needs and your preferences, it has everything you need. You're ready to go. You don't have to set up a separate tarp and put all these pieces of equipment together to build your hammock kit. It's all there. You've got the bug net, you've got the hammock, you've got the rain cover, all of it in the system. So that makes it very simple, very easy to use. You can just pull this thing, whip it out, and have it set up in just a really short period of time. So overall, a really, really good product that I know I'm going to get a lot of use out of in the years to come. All right, guys, thanks for watching. This concludes our review on the Lawson Hammock Blue Ridge Camping Hammock. Feel free to leave your comments and questions below. Make sure you subscribe to our channel, and don't forget to look us up on Facebook, Twitter, and our blog.